the best of times, it was the worst of times. And how true that is, even today. In fact, especially today, because it's sort of the end of an era. As some of you will know, I've been trying to keep my old DeWalt 3501 together for quite a long time. And it sort of deserves it because we've been friends for such a long time. But unfortunately, my dear old friend has been making some very weird noises lately, and I just decided it was time for a new bandsaw, and it arrived today.
Tonight's prizes are a workshop manual, ooh, a rip fence rail, a rip fence, a miter fence, a bag of knobs, a couple of wheels, a bag of nuts and bolts. A very heavy cutting table. A stand. And tonight's star prize, a record power bandsaw. To do is get it to look like the picture. I have to get that on there. I think that's all the construction of the bandsaw complete now. I still have some adjustments to do. I have to square up the blade and the table and things like that. But apart from that, I think it's time that we fired this baby up and made some sawdust. What do you say? Well, unfortunately, we can't because the saw has been supplied with a faulty on-off switch. Well, I've been in contact with the supplier. They were very polite, very helpful. They got in contact with the manufacturer's record power. They said, oh yeah, that's a problem. They didn't know about this before. Anyway, it seems to me that they actually kind of knew that this sort of thing was going to happen because it's actually in the manual. They have promised that they're going to send me a replacement switch, which is infinitely preferable to me. I don't want to have to wrap it all up and post it all back. It cost over £60 to have it posted here. I don't want to waste a whole lot of money and a whole lot of time and a whole lot of effort moving this thing. So if they sent me a switch, great, sounds fine, if we can get that sorted out. But sadly, that is not the only problem that there was with this saw. This blade guard. Was so bent out of shape that the blade would not come out. I also realised that the blade guard had been fitted so poorly that when you use the up and down mechanism, this thing here, the blade guard was fouling the upper wheel so that it couldn't go up.
As you can see here, I had to put an enormous amount of force to straighten this out and widen the gap. This is the way it should have come from the shop.
Aha! Now, this is something we've been waiting for. Let's make sure this is actually what I think it is. Goes down there. That's that. Okay, let's see what happens now. Hooray! At last!
Well, all that was about 6 weeks ago, and I'd love to be able to say that everything was plain sailing, but actually it turned out there were even more problems with the saw. First thing that I discovered was that the blade guide bearing assembly at the bottom of the saw was very sloppily fitted. It wasn't faulty, it had just been made in such a way that you couldn't get the thrust bearing up near the blade. It took me a while to figure it out. I don't understand how it got out of the factory fitted like that. It looked like it had been fitted by somebody who didn't know what they were doing. Then when I did get the saw set up all nice and tickety-boo, I still couldn't get it to cut straight, and the blade marks on it were dreadful. After a while I concluded it must be a bad blade, so I sent off for some new blades.
Oh, can I just butt in at this point and say that I bought the new bandsaw blades from Tuff Saws? Let me just show you. Tuff Saws were fantastic. They were very speedy, excellent quick service, good price for the blades. Their website was a little bit tricky to use, but maybe that was just me. But above all, for somebody living in Northern Ireland, the postage and packaging was very cheap, and I was really impressed with their service. So in my opinion, buy your bandsaw blades from Tuff Saws.
Thank you very much. I had to conclude that the saw had been supplied with a bad blade. Now, again, I do not understand why Record Power would send out a good tool with a bad blade. Does that make sense to you? I don't get it. Anyway, now that I have the good blades on, thanks to the good people at Tuff Saws, it is cutting beautifully. I could not be more pleased. Great, lovely, super duper, wonderful, smashing, fabulous, lovely, you know, nice. Well, I'm saying that everything is wonderful and tickety-boo and lovely and smashing and super and wonderful, but actually, I still have a problem with this, so let me show you. This rip fence is very sturdily made, but unfortunately it's a very clumsy rip fence. Like most bandsaw users, I want to be able to take the rip fence off whenever I want to. It won't come off if I take it along this way. Wouldn't it be easier if I moved this to this side? Then I could have this the full length and take it right off. Well, like most right-handed users, I like to have the rip fence on the left-hand side so that I can use my favorite hand to push the material through the blade. To have it on the other side would be a little bit awkward. The only way that I can get it so that I can take it off with this swinging action wastes all this space. For me, that sticks out 7 inches. You might be saying, Mark, isn't this rip fence thing just a bit of whinging on your part? Well, I think it's debatable. The rip fence is something that I find clumsy, difficult to use, not impossible to use, but it could be a lot better, and I certainly am going to have to come up with some sort of improvement to it. Just while I'm on the subject of whinging about things, this table insert is, it's not the greatest. And I thought about getting a replacement one for it, but £11? £11 for a piece of plastic? I don't think so. I think there's going to be a piece of plywood put in there. So after all those things, am I upset? Was it a bad buy? Absolutely not. This is a terrific tool. I'm very pleased with it. It's built like a battleship and it will certainly outlast me. And I hope somebody else after me will get the good of it as well. Am I disappointed with Record Power? I gotta say, yes, I am. I do not understand how a company of their reputation could possibly have let this get into the shops like that. Anyway, I'm still very happy with it. Everything is good. It might take us a few years to get used to each other. And I promise that I'm gonna let you know how I get on with it in the future. You'll certainly see it being used in all my subsequent videos. In the meantime, thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate you looking in. God's greatest blessings on you. Let's do this again real soon.